Hey guys, what's up? JS2Cents here. I'm pretty sure we're live. It says starting soon, but soon is now. Hey guys, JS2Cents and my co-host, Mr. Barnacles. How are you?
I am doing great, sir. How are you?
I'm doing okay. It's been a couple of weeks hiatus now. 3 weeks ago was our last show. So I'm going to go ahead and roll the intro, get us into the damn show so that we can cut loose a little bit and be completely normal and all that good junk. Anyway, roll that intro.
Yellow!
Oh man, it's been a long 3 weeks. So, Jerry, tell everyone what you've been up to lately.
I have not been sick miraculously for like a whole week. Woohoo!
How'd you manage that?
I don't know, dude. Maybe I just stopped eating like expired food or something.
Did you stop eating the trash food that you told us a story about a couple months ago? Couple weeks back, whatever it was, somebody was digging in the trash eating food.
Yeah, that's a bad habit. I was kind of hoping you wouldn't bring that up.
Free food is free food, right?
It's like if you go to a restaurant and you eat the leftovers left on somebody else's plate, you're actually helping them out because they don't have to, you know, waste that garbage space. I think it's smart.
If the raccoons can do it and the rats can do it, by God, Jerry, you can do it.
Damn straight. Damn straight.
So anyway, guys, we're back. Glad, I think. I think I'm glad. I'm not sure.
I'm glad.
Hair poking me in the eye right now. I don't know. I didn't get a haircut this week, so this is what my golden head of lovely locks looks like.
And it is growing out a little.
You, on the other hand, looks like you're preparing for war over there, I guess.
It's always a war. It's always a war, Jay.
Well, YouTube in itself.
Being a YouTube producer is a complete and ongoing war.
And because it's going to happen before next Thursday, let me be the first to congratulate you on that silver plaque you're about to be getting from YouTube on that 100,000 subscribers. Hopefully I'll get mine before Christmas sometime, but anyway, you know. I'm quite honestly happy that you could still grace me with your presence here on this show, because I know there's bigger and better things in your future. I'm going to miss you, my God.
I'm not going anywhere.
We're normal. I'm fine.
I told everybody I got to hit 500,000 before I start ignoring everybody and flying around in my helicopters and stuff.
500,000 before you start ignoring people below, like, I think it was like 200, I think is the threshold. That's the floor. Anything below that, you're kind of like, I can't talk to you.
Yeah, that's how it works, right?
I don't remember what the handbook said. I didn't really pay attention to that chapter because I'm not there yet.
Yeah. We'll see how it goes. But seriously, I think we're going to be all right. I think I'm still pretty good at responding to people on Twitter and that whole book face thing, and I think it's going to be all right, Jay.
Book face. Yeah, speaking of media and stuff, I've totally neglected my website over the last week because of my trip to Chicago and whatnot. And by the way, you guys out there in Chicago, you guys have some crazy-ass weather. I'm just going to say, I'm totally used to the consistency of Southern California. It's consistently dry and hot. But man, the time I was there, the week I was there, it was 41 degrees, and then it was 75 degrees, and then it was windy, and then it was raining, and then it was hot, and then it was cold. It was like, you know what? I could use a little bit of consistency here. Aren't you guys like 91 degrees up there right now today in Seattle?
Yeah, I think it hit about 91 when I jumped in my car.
Isn't that already like the apocalypse for where you're at?
For Washington, yeah. That's like basically we're like running around dying and stuff at that temperature. Well, you saw what I did. As soon as I got home, first thing I did was install an air conditioner in the bedroom.
That's the weirdest thing to me. You're like, oh, let's put the air conditioning away for the winter. Our house is like, I'm assuming you don't have central air in that house then.
No, I've got this thing that turns gas into fire, and that's it.
Really? What's that called?
It's called a furnace.
We don't have that.
You don't have a furnace? You just have one of those heat pump jobbers?
We just open the window.
Put this hot air out. Oh, I see what you did there.
Yeah,
I see what you did there, but for air conditioning, you get that from the central, don't you?
Although I choose not to open the windows now because, one, it's really hot. Two, there's fires burning already, which we were all afraid of in this area with how dry it's been. Some people on the news may see there's some wildfires going on, like literally right up the road. So everything is like dusty and ashy right now, more so than my ashy, dry, like psoriasis. No, I'm just kidding. But
and you probably got a bunch of kids running around magnifying glasses.
No, people are asking what I'm holding. It's just a piece of acrylic tube from leftover from what I cut yesterday. So anyway,
you like holding your acrylic tube, do you, Jay?
I love holding my tube. I just can't get it out of my hands. But the problem is it's slippery. It keeps falling out of my hands every now and then. I drop it.
Don't drop the tube, Jay. Don't drop the tube.
So anyway, you wanted to have some a little bit of structure and topics today. My question is, did you pick anything?
No.
I didn't think so. The 1 week, I'm like, Jerry, you're like, hey, I want to have some topics. I'm like, okay, pick them. You're like, will do. I'll do that. Yeah, I'll do it.
You found a good topic, though. You found a topic that I think we can beat to death. The VPN and the Hulu thing.
But I think it's a double-edged sword. I think it's a, I think it's good and it's bad in the same sense. So a couple weeks back, we talked about the shit going on with Netflix and Comcast and how they agreed to pay Comcast for, you know, to not slow down their traffic, right? Yep. And you and Tech Syndicate both talked about Red Leader. Oh, sorry. You and Tech Syndicate talked about, like, hey, the way to get around that is have a VPN. They can't trace you. Well, exactly. Hulu is now blocking traffic to VPNs.
Yeah, which raises the question, if they can block traffic to VPNs, one, how are they figuring out that they're VPNs? And two, if they can block it, what's stopping everybody else from doing it? And then we're screwed, because VPNs were like my solution to get around this whole net neutrality bullshit if it ever came to light.
Yeah, but look at Hulu's reasoning for it. I don't know if you read the article. I did read the article, and the reasoning for it is that Hulu is only licensed to serve the products, the TV shows and the movies that they're licensed for, to the U.S. only. It's a U.S. only product. So the only way they know where they're streaming the traffic to is to be able to trace the IPs and where they're going. So if they can't bounce back and get the IP, they have no idea where it's going. Therefore, they won't serve the traffic because it's against their license to serve somewhere else outside of the U.S. That's the reason why they're doing it. But the thing is that it keeps people like you and I, who legitimately need VPNs, from having a VPN and using a service that we subscribe to.
Well, and what about the businesses that, like, VPN is their business, right? I mean, are they just out of business? Because if you can't connect to anybody, I mean, what's the point of having a damn VPN?
Exactly. I mean, let's face it, the VPNs have many more pros than they do cons, but now that's the way that these companies are getting around the anonymity of the internet, which we all would love, the anonymity of the internet. It's good and bad.
I like to be anonymous. I absolutely love to be anonymous on the internet.
Exactly. I mean, some of the questionable site that you go to, you know, I would probably not want that traced back to me.
Yeah, I don't want to be identified on those sites. No way.
Yeah.
You know, I want my secret name to stay a secret on there, you know, and use my VPN so my IP address says that I'm connecting from Dallas, Texas.
I see Jose Acevedo, whatever, in the chat said...
Throw an accent on that. All right.
He was like, fuck Hulu. Hulu sucks. Yeah, that's fine, but we're talking about the situation, not necessarily Hulu. It's what keeps Netflix from doing it.
Okay, Hulu does not suck, first of all. I actually like Hulu because...
I do have a Hulu Plus account.
I do too. It's the only thing that actually has my shows on it, like, immediately. Well, as close to immediately as possible. But that aside, just like Jay was saying, we're talking about the same practice being applied. If a VPN can be identified as a VPN, which first and foremost, it shouldn't be identifiable. They would only be able to identify it by its IP range and who it's registered under.
Whoa.
But if companies can do that, we're screwed.
Yeah, whatever you just said, I didn't hear it.
Oh, wow. No, I was just saying we're screwed if they can identify VPNs, because that defeats the whole point.
Exactly.
I mean, the whole idea of a VPN is you're vectored onto the internet through a different IP address. And right. So what I have to assume here is, if Hulu can block a VPN, they have some way of detecting it's a VPN. And that's what I don't understand, is how are they doing that? Are they going to the network registers and saying any IP ranges that are registered to VPN companies, they're just going to block them all?
Yeah, I don't know exactly how they're doing it.
Because a VPN is just it's another step in a route. So
right.
They would just see it as an IP address. You send traffic to it, you receive traffic from it. They wouldn't know it was a VPN. It's not like they send something in the packet header saying, hey, I'm coming from a VPN.
And it's not like they can necessarily resolve anything from the browser.
Yeah,
I don't know. I don't know. But, I spent a lot of time thinking about this today, earlier when I texted you about it. I don't know exactly how, like you said, I don't know how they can tell, but I also don't, I mean, what if it's a VPN IP that's resolving in the U.S., but you're outside of the U.S.? It doesn't necessarily stop anyone from outside the U.S., right? So that's why they're just blanketly blocking the entire IP ranges they believe are registered to VPN companies. It doesn't make sense.
Yeah, and the other thing is, I'd imagine if they were blocking VPNs based on them being, like, VPN services, what about all the illegal VPNs, right? What about
if
you're going to be a pirate and stuff, you're going to be routing through networks that are, like, somebody, you know, setting up a VPN through their Comcast modem so that somebody can go through it. I mean, it's just like with the gun laws. Everybody's like, oh, ban all the guns and criminals won't have them. No, ban all the guns and then people can't legally buy them, so the criminals are the only ones that have them. That's exactly where this is going, if it's true.
Mason Haynes says, Jerry, say my name to prove this is live. This is my show, God damn it, and I said your name to prove that this is live.
I am the co-host. I am the co-host here, people.
No, no, no. Let's face it. You're the host now. You're the host. I just hand it over to you. In fact, when are we going to host this on your channel? That way I can mooch some subs, huh? 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 Huh?
I don't have any bandwidth, though.
You have three internets.
I have three internets, but they're not bonded. I have to use one internet for one connection. I can't just say, hey, distribute my video across all three. I can't do that.
My upload bit rate is only 1.3 megabits. You don't have a connection with 1.3 megabits, and that's also while it's sending video to you, so...
Wait a second, you're only using 1.3 megabit?
Yeah, 1.3 megabit is my upload for the stream and video to you.
Oh, so I can totally do this then. Never mind.
Absolutely. Yeah, so there, you guys heard it. Jerry's now leaving TikTok. God damn it!
I'm not leaving TikTok. We're just moving TikTok over to my channel and changing all the graphics. That's it. And you just have to be quiet. You only speak when you're spoken to, Jay. God damn it. You be quiet with your big sexy hair.
Do I have to hold the talking stick? If I hold the stick? Jerry, do I have to hold your stick to talk?
Yes, you do. As a matter of fact, we should do that. Be like, all right, guys. And then I put it like in a box and UPS it to you. And then we just sit here and wait.
Wait. Yeah. Yeah. So you talked about illegitimate VPNs, the Pirate Bay, people in there are talking about BitTorrent. I read an article today, too, that talked about there's a guy being sued for $34 million by the UFC because he uploaded 174 UFC fights through a BitTorrent. So
that sounds about right.
Yeah, he's now being sued for $34 million in damages by UFC. So the digital age scares me right now where... people are not, I don't think they're realistically able to put a value to the crime, right? How do you determine how much money you lost by uploading something to a torrent? You can't track how much it's been distributed.
No, but that's the problem is they take a worst case scenario and use that as their estimate. And they always do.
Yeah,
they did this for like the MP3 stuff. It's like, oh, they distributed a BitTorrent. So based on like their upstream and their maximum, if somebody was downloading 24 hours a day, this is how many copies could have been distributed.
Yeah.
It's like, it's all hypothetical.
Now, you and I both are on the legitimate side of things. We don't use pirated software. We don't condone it. When people try and give us like pirated solutions to things we need right away, you and I both are like, no thanks. So, yeah. But I mean, I don't know. I mean, this is like the age that we live in now. This is the age we live in. Everyone is sharing. Everyone is torrenting. Everyone is bootlegging and stuff. So I feel like the punishments aren't necessarily fitting the crime, right? I mean, if you went and stole a DVD from the store, and you made copies and gave it to your friends, what does it say on the DVD piracy like little screen? It's like $175,000.
I think it's $250,000 last time I checked, and up to 5 years imprisonment.
Okay, so how is what are they gonna do? Are they gonna then? Aren't they able to say that's like per copy if they wanted to necessarily go to the full extent of the law?
Yeah, the problem is they're going after mass distribution because if you have a CD, you can only burn so many copies of it, and you only sell so many copies of it. But if you give away, if you set up like a torrent site, and then you have 50 people distributing, then 100, then 1,000, then 100,000. It rapidly gains velocity and more copies are made. It spreads much faster. So that's their argument. But the counter argument to that is how many of those people would have legitimately bought that thing if they hadn't have just copied it? Because a lot of the pirates, they just download like for the hell of it. You know, so you can't pin it on all them. It's like, and you can't quantify that. You can't say how many of those people would have legitimately bought a copy otherwise.
Yeah, and not to mention too, I think that there's some side effects punishment that goes along with it anyway. I mean, most of the time, you can't get anything legitimately clean off of Pirate Bay or any of that anyway. I mean, everything has its... You know, I'm not going to necessarily trust a pirate to download and be like, oh, this guy out of the goodness of his heart was sharing this with everybody.
Yeah, so, no, that's true. Because even back in my youth, I mean, a lot of the skills and stuff that I picked up were through nefarious means and doing stuff that I shouldn't have done when I was younger. And a lot of the groups that I align myself, I mean, with like Razor and stuff like that, some of them are still around today. I mean, they all had people that would actually put stuff in the software specifically to root and backdoor machines when the software was installed. It was considered a trade-off. They package, distribute the pirated software, and in return, they take a backdoor on your computer and use it for DDoS attacking people and sending emails and stuff like that. I'm not going to say all groups are like that. Not that's not the goal of all groups, but some of the software that's distributed is like that.
Yeah.
And if it's not like that, some people will take the software from that distributor, then add their own crap to it, and then upload it as if it's an untouched copy. But you have no way of knowing. That's the problem with that, is you don't know if it was touched. And then you have to run your virus scanner and hope to God that your definitions are up to date and catch whatever's in there.
Yep. Well, you know, it's the same thing too of why I never, ever, ever jump on public networks. When I'm at the airport or I'm at a Starbucks or something like that, I never, ever jump on those networks.
You don't want to get hacksword.
Exactly. And guys, I turned down the headphones. I think you guys were hearing Jerry echo because my headphones were picking them up in the mic, so which was slightly.
Oh, it might actually be my headphones too, because I got to, oh, crap, it is my headphones.
Jeez. People are asking if I'm using my headphone mic. There's no mic attached to this anywhere, so it's actually the Yeti right there.
Let me turn that down.
Schwag. Well, there's 510 people in here. I'd like to thank all 510 of you for joining. All 10 of my subscribers and all 500 of Jerry's.
That's... Shut up, dude. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it no more.
I love the fact that you're about to hit 100K because it's so much fun to give you shit now.
I know, man. That's all I get. Every time I log in, I wake up in the morning, go sit on the shitter and like pull out my phone and I'm like, Jay, oh, hitting 100K, oh, blah, 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 blah.
Hey, no. No, I've only mentioned it two or three times and all three of them were to congratulate you and then give you shit.
They resonated in my head, though, Jay. They resonated.
I like to play with the acrylic tube.
Apparently. You know what's funny is it kind of looks like a crack pipe. It does a little bit. You should be careful. Hey, somebody meme that and put it in crack reference on it.
Please don't. Please don't do that. My mom would be incredibly disappointed in me.
Do it with the hairdo. That just would be funny. You sit there with your pipe going... That's some smoke coming out of it. Put a torch in there. Oh God, I love it. I love it. No, these damn these headphones. God, these things are so comfortable. But when I had them on the helmet, I had to crank them up so loud that they were picking up on the mic. I'm sorry, guys. Apologies.
I'm sorry. What?
What? So anyway, what we're talking about? We're talking about the. How pirates is bad and gay.
Pirates is bad and gay. So are drugs. Don't do drugs. Okay. Don't do drugs. Okay. Okay. I'm holding up a crack pipe. Don't do drugs. Okay.
Don't do drugs. Okay.
Do what I say. Know what I do. Okay. Quick, Jerry, pick a topic for tech. Quick. We can't get too off topic.
Quick. Okay. For tech. I'm blank mind. What are we talking about here? Let's go to the chat.
Okay.
In the chat. Oh, I see Titan Z's.
No! Okay. Topic shotgun round. Somebody pick a topic. Somebody put up topics and we'll pick one and we'll talk about it.
Oh, we're talking about the Titan Z. It's like the Dacia Sandero from Top Gear.
No.
Dacia Sandero, Jay.
No.
Brendan Burke says Jerry speak really close to the mic.
Wait, meme contest. Jerry, make a face and we'll need to pick a meme. Make a face. Go. I was looking at my own camera, so the eyes were looking at it. I looked at yours, and I couldn't help but laugh.
Jay and I made the observation that if we make funny faces, they inevitably always become memes. So now it's all about creating funny faces. Like, I don't know. Maybe if I stick with my
you have nose. To look. You have to look to your right, and we'll make a face at each other.
There we go. There's some meme material for you.
Oh, God. All right. SanDisk announces 4 terabyte SSD. Boring! It's a big SSD! Yay!
Linus's Lambo. Oh, should we talk about Linus's Lambo? We haven't talked about his Lambo in a while.
But I thought that's because he upgraded to Learjet.
That's true. He doesn't have the Lambo anymore,
he's
guys.
He's just passed 750,000 sub. That's Lambos are now for poor Linus. Now he's rich Linus.
Like, what is it, at 500K, don't you get an aircraft carrier? Isn't that like... I thought that's like what you do when you get.
I thought that was at the 1 million.
Yeah, and if you're PewDiePie, you're basically God. Like at PewDiePie's level, he actually has like powers, like Scientology powers.
Jay's new computer. I don't have a new computer.
No, the one you're building.
Redmond. That's not my computer. You know, people are starting to people are thinking with how long this build is taking and how much I've pimped it that like, oh, it's really Jay's new build. It's not. It's not my build. It's right. It's right there if you guys want to see it.
Hello!
You know you're going to clone it. You know, it's looking so good. You know you're going to clone it. Ugh. Jay, show your tits.
Look at that.
I wasn't saying that. Somebody in chat was. somebody's asked about the Oculus. Do you guys want to know about the Oculus?
That'll be a meme.
Oh my gosh, here it is.
God, put it on, quick.
All right, hey, keep it in your pants, guys. Keep it in your pants. Here it is. Oh, except for it's backwards.
No, it's not. It's,
oh, it
it's,
isn't.
It's
this is
backwards
on
your camera.
All right, hold on here. Oh, damn it, it's tangled up.
Jerry, look at the stream. That's just how I'm going to leave the video from now on.
See that? Just keep pimping that. All right.
This is so much better to look at than me.
We got to put on the Rift here.
Every time I see someone wearing a Rift, I'm thinking it's like a blind version of a snorkel. I picture that's what somebody who's blind wearing a snorkel would look like.
It's like somebody put a dive mask on me and they just spray painted it.
Especially when it's off, right?
Where are you? There. All right, can you guys see it? I'm blind right now. I don't actually have it plugged in.
Are you waiting for someone to say something to you?
Yeah, I'm trying to the chat, but I can't because I turned the Rift on.
Uh-huh. Where's the box?
Oh, God, it's a box.
You dropped the box.
All right, I'm gonna take this off.
Why do people keep thinking of Hackintosh? Screw Hackintosh.
Okay. The Rift. I'm gonna give you guys a rundown. There will be a full video review of it, but I'll tell you right now, do not buy the DK1. Don't do it. It's got such low resolution. The effect is cool. It's awesome when you're looking at stuff like this far away. But I tried to play iRacing with it and I felt like I was a 96.
And I tried to play with him and it was incredibly difficult to get him to click anything anywhere on the screen.
it was absolutely horrible. It was horrible. Now the motion tracking, I heard people saying that the motion lagged on it. There was no lag at all that I could notice. Even when I was playing iRacing and I was doing the world demo, I could move my head around as fast as I wanted, and it felt like it was perfectly one-to-one. It's the closest I've ever seen to actual natural movement, and it didn't make me sick at all. Like, I was playing iRacing for probably a good hour with it on, and I didn't have any ill effects. But there is a little bit of blur on the screen when you're moving your head, like motion blur, like it's, you know, a cheaper LCD, which it is. I mean, it's a development kit. But after using it, I can tell you right now, as long as they can get a higher resolution screen in it with less screen door, because honestly, when you're playing, it looks like this.
it's like you're playing the game looking through pantyhose.
I mean, with cataracts.
With cataracts. But if they can fix that and get the resolution high enough and then get that screen door effect gone, oh my God, revolutionary. I'll tell you right now. I mean, the hype is real if they can pull it off. But after using it, I can understand why they haven't gone to market yet, because they have some huge problems that they have to solve for this to be like a legitimately good thing.
Patrick Barron is suggesting I buy you a Titan Z for your 100K subs.
I think I like it. I think that's.
I think you should buy me one for your 100K subs.
Jay, I am poor. If watching my videos hasn't taught you one thing, is that you should know I'm poor, Jay.
Compared to like Bill Gates, yeah.
And PewDiePie. And Tobuscus and iJustine. Yeah, I'm poor.
iJustine actually doesn't make that much money off YouTube. She has more endorsements through other things.
Does she really? I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I'm supposed to meet her at Vlogger Fair this year.
That's cool.
See if I do, though. Oh, hey, Sarah Rogerson says, Barnacles, my husband is obsessed with you. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
That's weird.
I have a feeling he's going to leave me for you. Oh, okay, maybe he is bi. Damn you chubby bastard.
I agree.
Is he Canadian by chance? I don't know what it is, man. I don't know what it is. I have a lot of gay Canadians that chase me around. Actually, I wonder if Colonel's watching. He usually sneaks in here. Canadian Colonel, if you're watching, type something in chat. I want to know if you're voyeuring me again. He probably is. All right, what is it? Man, everybody's on the GPUs. You're right, Jay. GPUs is hot, man.
They are, literally, unless you water cool them.
That blew my mind.
Especially if you overclock them. I keep dropping my crack pipe.
You need, well, too much crack will do that to you. Mm-hmm. Oh my God. So let's see.
Do you guys think this hairdo works for me? I'm thinking about change.
No, I love your hair, Jay.
I feel like I should be at the beach right now and be like, what's up, tubular? Yeah.
You see me shred that wave? Oh, dude.
That was gnarly. Poor Jerry, you'd be rich if you stopped buying Starbucks every day. Guys, I spend more on Starbucks every day because Jerry buys a tall, I get the Vente.
Starbucks is addictive, though.
It's dude, like- okay. Okay, so I just finally, like, over the last month was like, you know what? I might as well just go ahead and register a card on the app and just keep reloading it. Dude, I hit the 30 stars in the first month.
Yeah, it actually took me over a month to hit like, the first gold level.
The first gold? I know. I was like, right now I could get a custom metal gold card if I wanted it.
Like, you can actually go in there, and it's like you just show them the card, and they let you behind the counter and just let you use the machine.
Look, this is no joke, and I'm not proud of this, because Starbucks truly is a freaking addiction. If you guys know, if you guys drink enough Starbucks, you know there becomes a while there where you're like, okay, I meant to keep driving by, and now I'm in the drive-thru. I don't know. I walk into the place, because I don't like to go through the drive-thru. I actually walk in, and I get to the register, and I pay. My drink is already there. Because they see me walk in, I'm waiting in line, they're making it. They've already done the cup.
Dude, you should just screw with them one day and just walk in and then, like, use the bathroom and leave.
No, I've screwed with them once before, though, when I get up there and they're like, here's your drink. I was like, oh, but today I was going to order this and this and this. And they're like, oh, really? I'm like, nah, I'm just kidding.
Here's the problem with me with Starbucks is it's right on the way to work. It's so convenient because there's like 88 million of them between my house and work. And I always, in the morning, I go get my car, and I drive, and I'm like,
I gotta cut you off for a second. Oh, no, Tech just said I look better than half the girls at his school. What, do you go to dog college?
Wait, what'd he say? You?
I look better than half the girls at his school.
I don't know. I think you're looking pretty sexy there,
I think he goes to dog college.
Dog college?
Must.
Somebody out there said talk about 3D printing, but I'm like, what?
You have a whole channel for that.
It's like, yeah, just go watch my videos on my channel. I'm going to be doing more. I mean, here, this will cheer up all the 3D printing guys. See this?
Oh, yeah, lower.
Still removing the
support. Oh, my material. God.
I got to use a Dremel to take the support material off because it got a little too friendly with
it. I'm one of those people who thinks that 3D printed stuff comes off looking pristine. That is gnarly ugly.
No, that's a lie. That's a lie. When you 3D print something with support material, it comes off looking like a bucket of shit. And then you gotta take a Dremel and pliers and bust off all these little chunks. Actually, it was my fault. I'll take responsibility. When I printed this, I had the support settings like on extreme. So the support it built was like damn near unremovable. So I need to reprint it again without support at a higher resolution. I just haven't done it. Anyways, there you go, guys. I'm doing it. Finally. Everybody's been begging for it. Here's a gun. Everybody's gonna come get me. Pew, 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 pew. Actually, it goes this way because that's where the stock connects on.
I was like, why is the trigger in front of the magazine? It's not a pop-up.
I'm like watching the chat now that I'm showing this. Everybody's going to be like, oh my God, it's good.
It's a blue gun. He's holding it backwards. Oh no.
When I started printing that, everybody like freaked out and was like, oh my God, you're going to get in trouble. And it's like, no. The law states that you, as an American, can make your own weapons. You can make your own guns. They just, all they have to do is fall within the code of what a firearm can be legally, and you can't transfer it or sell it.
Dude,
I can print as many AR lowers as I want. I can print as many Liberator pistols as I want.
Seriously.
And I shoot them and stuff. It's completely legal. I could walk right into the police department with a loaded Liberator.
And shoot everybody if you wanted.
No. Well, you couldn't shoot anybody.
Sure you can. In America, you are perfectly free to do it, but you are not free of consequence.
In the early 1800s, maybe. No, I'm just kidding. but it's one of those things where it's like a lot of people don't realize that. But yeah, go on YouTube and do a search for, what is it, pipe zip gun. Like you can go to Home Depot and buy $10 worth of like kitchen sink pipe and build a 12-gauge shotgun, which is 100 times more effective than anything you'll ever 3D print.
Yeah. People are just afraid of 3D printed stuff because it looks so real. I shouldn't say real. It just looks so much like, you know, a legitimate metal rifle.
Oh, dude, I just checked the Twitter feed. It looks like people are already starting to post screenshots. Oh my god!
Really?
Oh my god!
Okay, I've got 41 notifications. Let me see. That's great.
That's awesome. Did somebody say crack? Oh god! Thank you so much. @itsrob_. I don't know why you have an underscore, but @itsrob_.
I just retweeted it.
Oh my god. Oh, I am legend said, why is Jay smoking crack on stream? You know what's sad is that it actually looks exactly like you're smoking a crack pipe.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, Jay, that now all the crackheads are gonna come sub you, dude. You're gonna get like 50,000 subs, and all they're gonna want to do is take.
And I'm such a sellout. I'm okay with it.
Yeah, you know what? All your whole comment section on Project Red Mist is gonna be, "Can I cut the pipes out of your computer?"
People are gonna be like, "People are gonna like, I now get the mist part."
Mist.
Oh jeez.
Oh my god. Oh, you guys are priceless. See, this is my favorite part of live streaming is just seeing what people come up with afterwards.
I'm sad that that is the only meme, but it totally wins. Hey, it's Rob. Do you have Battlefield 4? And if not, do you want a code? I would totally give you one for that meme.
No, that I just retweeted that, dude. That is priceless.
So did. Oh god, let's see. There's another one.
Another one.
You're not tagged in it. I'm gonna retweet it right now. This is the best part.
This is out of control.
Look at Twitter, quick.
Okay. I am. Alright, here we go. Here it is. Wait, no, I just keep seeing the same one.
Hold on.
Oh no, here. Is this it? Hold on.
Yeah, the cocaine one.
No, I just said did this one see. I haven't seen that one yet.
I just retweeted it, so you have to look at your feed. Not the notifications, look at the feed.
Feed? Okay, hold on.
Look at the home feed.
I don't know how to use Twitter, Jay! I don't! Oh, here we go. Cocaine, not even once. Oh my god! Cocaine, not even once.
Oh my god. If you guys can't see that, you gotta look at the Twitter. You gotta follow on the Twitter.
Now you have to go over to Twitter. You have to. That is just that one's getting retweeted again. That is priceless.
Someone's all that face though. Come on, it's priceless.
Yeah, see that's the thing is it's like I'm not that good at putting that kind of stuff together. You know, it's like you had to actually get two screenshots from two completely different spots and they fit together perfectly.
You know, I see some of those memes and or those like your e-card greetings and some of them are so hilarious. And I'm like, why didn't I think of that? Why didn't I think of that? I thought that. Why didn't I think about it?
It's absolutely hilarious. Hey, guys, if you're enjoying the stream, hey, hit that like button. We got 556 people in here and only 236 likes. Those likes help us.
Jaffer.
You hit that like button, YouTube sends us a kitten.
I see, and then we kill it.
No, we don't.
No,
we don't talk about that. Come on,
sorry.
Beat it and give it a litter box. Yeah,
I already have 11 retweets and 21 favorites on that. Did someone say crack?
Dude, that was the best thing ever. God, what, did I not give you guys a good enough face? Jeez, go get an actual
look,
crack.
I'm the one with hooker hair and what looks like a crack pipe piece of acrylic in my hand.
Right, I can't, dude. I cannot one up you tonight. I really can't. That was
when I could beat it.
I can see right now after seeing that. I don't think you can do that. I don't think.
Jerry, look at the camera.
Oh, let's see here.
There you go. We're taking the addiction to the next step. Look at Skype.
Wait, you're not even streaming video. I just see a little spinny.
Oh, I'm not? Really?
You're not streaming video, Jay. I can't see your video.
Here we go. Are you ready?
Oh, hey, hold on. Sarah Rogerson said, could you tell Luther Dutra you say hi? He's watching. See, I just did. Oh, no. No, stop giving him ammo. Stop.
Drugs are bad, okay? Don't do drugs.
Okay. No.
I mean it. These are not drugs. They're pieces of a computer, for crying out loud. But it's certainly suggestive.
All I've got is a Barnacles 3D printed knife, an AR-15 lower, and a TIE fighter. That's all I have.
Yeah, we are horribly bad.
Yeah.
Do anything that we're suggesting that it looks like a dude. I cannot keep up with the notifications.
Everybody wants me to make walkthroughs. Like my house? Or like, a game. Game walkthroughs.
I love how the real drug addicts, you're like, that's not a pipe!
That's not a crack pipe, you son of a bitch. I make crack pipes, and that's not a crack pipe.
That doesn't look anything like anything I've ever made.
Hey, if you're addicted to crack, we still welcome your patronage watching this stream, and thank you. So please hit that like button, even if you're a crackhead.
Yeah.
Jake, in a cup of mail.
I'm serious. It's Rob. It's Rob. You need to tell me if you want a Battlefield 4 code, because I said the other day, the best meme gets a Battlefield 4 code, and I don't care. That wins.
That wins the whole internet, dude. There's just, honestly, that's the best meme I've probably ever seen of you.
Yeah, ever. That's Battlefield 4. That's gonna be my new Twitter profile pic. No, I'm kidding.
That'd be awesome.
And we're like, hey, Asus, you want to do some business? Hold on. Okay, guys, you want to do some business? And suddenly, I'm uninvited to CES. Yeah.
Be like, Asus, I want a motherboard. Asus, give me a motherboard. Give me a motherboard. I want a motherboard, the one with the chips on it, and the memory.
Gerard 98 says he sent us a meme. Oh god, let's see.
Oh, I just made my.
I'm trying to check my Twitter, but my Twitter right now is like blip 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 blip.
It's news, the Twitters.
It's kind of hard. Dude, well, the Twitter that is anyway. The Twitter is. I wanted to clarify that.
I'm confused.
Okay, he said he would love one. All right.
Battlefield 4. All
right, it's Rob. You get the Battlefield 4 code. I'm going to send you a follow real quick.
Hey, Jesse Pinkman just says he wants to email me ideas. I'm scared.
When the ideas must be private. Yeah, terrifying. All right, Jerry, fill in some time real quick. Talk about something while I send him this code.
All right, what is Jerry going to talk about when you send him a code?
He's totally earned this code.
I gave people some shout-outs. We're talking about drugs. Yeah, drugs are bad. Don't do drugs. Just
drugs
me
are bad,
and Jay
okay.
doing drugs. What?
Drugs are bad. Guys, if I'm smoking anything, it's air, okay? I'm smoking air. It's a piece of acrylic! Come on! It's missing the other contraption.
It's what they all say. So!
It's a gateway pipe.
So let's see. What's coming up on the old Barnacles nerdgasm here? Well, I'm going to do the Oculus Rift review. That's probably going to be the next
video. Oh, sorry. Did I say that out loud?
And then after that, I'm
if it isn't going to be the rift, 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 rift intro, I would never watch it.
Shut up, Jay.
All right. See all that Star Wars stuff back there? That big, huge mound of pristine collector-level boxes? Yeah, I'm going to tear all those up and do videos. So if you're a Star Wars fan, you will either love those videos or you will hate me if you're a collector. You'll hate me and want me to die. But Chris Perillo said it was okay, so I'm doing it. I'm tearing them out of the boxes and I'm going to hang them from the ceiling. Take it, you collectors.
Take it. All right, keep talking. I'm still going. I'm still doing this.
All right, hold on. I'm going to take some stuff over the chat. So, okay, Greg Clark pooped today. Let's all give him a round of
woo-hoo!
Applause.
Yes.
You know, Greg. Woo! Woo!
Rob did it.
Slid out easy, brother.
Rob did another one. Cracker's going to crack.
All right, and Sarah says weed isn't a drug. Goodness. It's a plant. And if you live in, what is it, Washington? Is it Colorado in Washington? I think it's okay. Like, you can have that. I've never had it, but I'm not saying if a brownie got handed to me with some in it that I wouldn't eat it. I'm just saying. Let's see here. Potatoes are the worst drug imaginable. God, you're telling me.
Oh, you want to hear the worst part about this?
What?
It's Rob has the best meme, and I'm trying to give him a code. He's not even following me on Twitter. Does he deserve that code now?
Hey, you better follow Jay.
He's not even following me.
You better follow him.
That is totally jacked up.
And yes, he does still deserve the code.
He's like... He looks like he's 10, but I don't care. He's a 10-year-old doing crack memes.
Yeah, but let's be honest. What 10-year-old isn't doing crack memes this day and age?
Oh, my god.
That's actually better. If your kid's doing crack memes, that means he actually isn't out doing crack. So that's good. Well, hopefully. I hope he's not doing crack. Because when you're 10, you shouldn't do crack. Oh, another meme's up. That's pretty fun. What's wrong, officer?
I like the
What's
one that...
Wrong, officer?
I like the one Chase did of you. Crack had me like, and you're all, you're all just like chilling out.
Oh, these are awesome. These are awesome.
Rob, I'm trying to send you a Battlefield 4 code, but you know, if you don't want it.
You gotta follow him. I want to. You gotta follow him. Jerry learned G-code. I know G-code.
Now he's following me. There we go.
I know G-code. Actually, you know what? I don't even use a slicer when I 3D print, man. I'm so elite. I just open up Notepad and I write the G-code. I just straight up write it, line for line.
You're like, hold on. I gotta do the Merovingian of code here.
JN Gaming says, who do you prefer, NVIDIA or AMD? NVIDIA.
I have 3 780s.
I prefer NVIDIA, but then again, trust me, there's days where I want to switch to AMD. There's days where NVIDIA's drivers infuriate me so much, that I just want to...
He says he's 16. No, bro, you look like you're 12. I'm sorry.
That's what I want to do sometimes, NVIDIA and go to ATI. But then I stay with them for some reason, because they're like, oh, Jerry's, we lovers you. We lovers you, Jerry, stay with us. And then I'm like, okay, fine, it's cool.
Oh my god, every time I open that up now, I'm gonna feel really bad.
That gaming kid said I should teach my son to make crack memes and make them all. Or to make them lol.
Yeah, make all the memes!
He's a little young, though. He's only 4 years old. I'll wait until he's at least 8 before I have him do crack memes. And I might talk to his therapist, too, and see if maybe his therapist will work it into, like, he could do, like, some crack memes on paper. Because then, you know, get his finger dexterity up and stuff. No, that's a good idea. I'm going to do that. I'm going to recommend that.
Start a spam saying truffle shuffle. Guys, we've had an ongoing arrangement. If we get 1,000 likes, Jerry does the truffle shuffle. We're at 404. Oh, we have 40... Jerry.
What? This, like what?
Jerry, we have 404 likes. Apparently the page is broken.
Oh, page is broke. Stream's down. Damn it!
Or YouTube starts maintenance and we can't shut the stream down for 6 hours. I don't know, Jerry. I think we should do some sort of a marathon stream someday.
We should, like, a 24-hour stream?
Oh, God.
Or at the end, we're just like...
No, I've already done a 24-hour live stream at the Full Screen Studios in Hollywood when the Black Ops 2 launched. That was hard to do, man. I wasn't even on camera the whole time.
I bet.
I was with a group of people.
I'm going to go get us a topic. That's what I'm going to do.
Yes, get us a topic. We have 18 more minutes left in the stream. People have asked, why we only do an hour stream. You know what? Someone said, leave them wanting more.
You got to leave them wanting more, and I need that second hour afterwards to go use the bathroom. I'm sorry.
I'm going to get off here, and I'm going to go do more Project Redbist.
Ooh, episode 37 in the bathtub. God, you guys, we were just actually, this is funny. Let's tell them about this a little bit. Okay. So before Jay and I start a live stream, we literally were on Skype for probably about half an hour, 45 minutes before the live stream, just working things out and trying to get it working. I know it doesn't seem like that when we start the stream because everything goes to hell in the last 5 minutes, but we do.
It does every time.
But it's funny because the reason why we started the stream wearing a helmet and a wig is because we were just, the silliness was off the scale. Like, I told Jay that next time we need to record the previous 45 minutes, edit it together into a little video.
Who's wearing a wig?
You were.
No,
you're not wearing a wig.
I didn't get a haircut.
Where's my helmet? Where'd my helmet go?
Wait, which helmet are we talking about, Jerry?
The one on my head, Jay.
No,
We were joking around about Project Red Mist. We're just talking about how we should drag it out to 36 episodes. And by the 36th episode should be like him going to the guy's house or something and like doing a visitation of the machine after he's used it for a month, or him sitting in a bathtub with a bunch of candles around talking about like how cool water cooling is.
We also talked about we were going to have Red Mist YouTube channel, Red Mist Twitter, Red Mist mugs.
Don't forget 4chan. 4chan and Imgur. Oh, yeah.
Red Mist subreddit.
Yep.
We're going to drag it out. It's like my life's accomplishment. It can't be over. It's the one thing I've actually accomplished in this life.
Go ahead.
I feel bad, though. Red Mist has like obviously created an influx of people like, yeah, I want you to build me a PC. And I tell like all of them, sorry, no, can't, no can do.
Not
even you.
Not even me.
It would get up to Seattle and be just like a pile of broken parts by the time it gets through UPS. Red Mist pieces is what it is.
Guys, I would like to apologize first and foremost if I'm a little off my game today. I'm not exactly feeling 100%.
It's because he gave up drugs.
I gave up drugs. No kidding. Don't do drugs, kids. I'm actually going through some pretty shitty stuff right now. But I'm trying to be optimistic.
That means he's taking a poo.
Jerry, show your tits.
More like Project Cocaine. Did somebody say BF?
Red Mist sounds like a period. Project Red Mist. You can only build that computer 3 days out of the month. That's bad. That is really bad. Let's see. OnePlus One phone? What the hell is the OnePlus One phone? Why have I not heard of this?
The before and after crack. That was great. Somebody went back to my... grabbed a screenshot from my very first video I ever put up on YouTube and compared it to me today. That's actually a pretty bad transformation. I retweeted that.
Somebody did an I want to kill cats meme with you? That's a good one. Now it's getting retweeted. More like Project Cocaine.
Look at the one I just retweeted right now.
Crack bro. No,
look at the before and after.
Hold on, dude. I'm retweeting all these out of the scuba mask. Out the scuba mask.
Which one's on crack?
Oh, let me see here. God, you guys are out of control.
Remember, kids, if a stranger offers you drugs, say thank you because drugs are expensive.
Before crack and after crack.
I guess that was a screenshot from the very first video I ever put on YouTube.
This is awesome. So, Jay, we're going to talk about the OnePlus One. 2014 flagship killer phone, apparently.
What?
Go to OnePlus.net. Apparently, it looks like a thin and another Android phone. That's what it looks like.
Rob or whatever it was, underscore Rob, I don't remember his Twitter handle already. He was like, "Thank you so much. I'm 16, by the way, not 10." I DM'd him back. Nah, you're 10, bro. I'm a dick.
Yeah, okay. I don't know. I don't know this phone. Okay,
is that the one that Logan the other day put up? It was like,
yes, it is.
It's a pretty phone. But you know what? I'm so sick of the whole phone thing.
Are you sick of the phone thing?
I've had my iPhone 5 now. Shoot, it will be 10 years. Sorry, hold on. This is totally getting to me. Hold on. No, I've had it nearly. It'll be 2 years in September. Four more months? That's a lot. This is the longest I've ever owned a phone, and I think it's because I don't care how I treat it.
I just got used to it. That's the thing, is you get used to a phone, and it's really, really hard to adapt to everything else.
I've had a new phone every 12 months for like the last 5 years, and this is the first time I've kept a phone past an upgrade. I just don't care. I don't care about phones anymore.
I do, though. I do, Jay. I do. I just don't care about Android phones.
Yeah, like Justice Gash says, you know, hey, OnePlus One phone is intriguing. Check it out. Yeah, intriguing is cool. You know what I was more interested in for a while there was that upgradable phone. What was it called?
Oh, yeah. No, I know exactly which one you're talking about.
It was like a modular phone.
Yeah.
No, plop out the CPU and put in a new one. That was kind of cool, but God, talk about impractical, though. I mean, how expensive would that be?
Yeah, what the hell was it called? I thought it was like Project Morpheus or something like that.
I don't remember.
What the hell was it called? I'm trying to find it. I'm trying to find it on the internet. I can't find it on the internet. Woo!
Can't find something on the internet? That's never happened before.
Well, it's like every time I type stuff in, just porn comes up.
You should clear your history, bro. Clear your history. If someone ever hacks your Google account, they're probably going to log out for you.
Hey, I just found a site called thisiswhyimbroke.com.
Was it a picture of your man room?
Why won't they call? Okay, so, yeah, no, I find it's a lot of modular cell phone pictures, but no, I can't find the actual name.
Wasn't
of
it called, like, the Blocks or something like that? Blocks?
I mean, yeah, it's just a bunch of blocks you put together. The camera's a block, the storage is a block, the
block,
phone's
block,
a block.
Block, 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 block,
block, block, block, block, block, block. Just blocks everywhere. And I think I made the comment once that, like, I wouldn't want it because, like, if you were trying to answer it and pull it out of your pocket, it would just fall into a bunch of Lego pieces. Like, that would be bad and good. It'd be real bad and good. Let's see. God, I'm trying to check my stream here.
Talk about CSGO. That's a weird topic.
What, Counter-Strike?
Yeah. It's Counter-Strike Global Offensive. It's built off of something that's 12 years old.
Hey.
I do have CSGO, and it's funny. Every time I try and go back and play Counter-Strike, I keep trying to aim down sight, which, you know, doesn't work.
Oh, okay. Somebody corrected me. Project Morpheus is Sony's knockoff of the Rift.
That's right.
So Project Aura by Sony is Project Aura. Oh, my God. Everybody's got it now. Okay, we see it. Project Aura. Got it. So Project Aura is going to be the QB phone.
NK Chan says, just got in here and Jay's hair is getting my attention immediately.
Oh, yeah.
He feels it between the legs, I'm sure.
Wink. Yeah. Bob's your uncle and all that.
Uh-huh. I can't wink. My eyes close together. This is what it looks like when I wink. Are you ready? It doesn't work. It looks like I'm having a stroke.
Stop, Jay. Just stop.
It looks like I'm having a stroke, legitimately.
A little bit.
So I think I'm gonna rewatch this stream when I'm done, because I'm gonna immediately go to Project Red Mist right there. Check it out on my channel. It's a series. Mm-hmm. If you haven't seen it, right there, big computer, overpriced. It was like $6,000, something like that. I don't know.
That's nothing, dude. That's poor people computer.
You know what? You know what's sad is what this $6,000 computer could do compared to your $10,000 computer today.
Like, did it a lot more?
This is like legitimately twice the gaming power of your computer.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Do I need a new one, Jay?
Yeah.
Mine's still kind of pretty.
The nice thing about your X79, though, is the fact that you can just plop in an Ivy Bridge E and be happy with it. You don't need to go to X99.
Dude, all my coolant's going away, though.
It's evaporating. You know what? I could never have a reservoir on the outside of my case like that. I would have kicked that off so many times by now.
You have no idea how many times I've railed into that thing. It's just like near miss. I thought I broke it, and I didn't. So go acrylic.
Huh?
At least I didn't get a glass. If it was glass, I'd be screwed.
Oh, I know.
Everybody keeps asking me when I'm hanging up my Star Wars stuff. Probably maybe Sunday.
Like, you're going to hang it from strings and stuff?
Yeah, I'm gonna get fishing line and I'm gonna hang.
Are you gonna get little lasers too? That like little plastic lasers that are pew pewing in the middle of the room?
Maybe that actually sounds like a good idea. Maybe I could go get some like I don't know. Do they make like neon red like fishing line and then I could like connect it between the objects and do little explosions with cotton balls and stuff? Mm. Dude, I'm way too lazy for that. Way too lazy. Stuff hanging on the ceiling.
Do things explode in space when there's no oxygen?
Well, see, there's oxygen inside of the spaceship, and then that explodes.
Is that why it's just like poof and it's gone really fast?
It's like done. That's it. Yeah. That's how an explosion in space would look realistic. It'd be like,
you know what really blows my mind when I'm really bored sometimes is I try and think about and fathom the infinity of time. I like try to wrap my mind around infinity.
I think about the infinity of space.
It just keep going and going and
so
going.
So if we got together and we were really drunk, we'd basically be Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Like asteroids that have blown up millions of years ago that have not hit anything are still going.
Well, it's like I was watching, you know that Cosmos, the Cosmos show?
No.
Cosmos? Go watch it. It's got Neil deGrasse Tyson and Seth MacFarlane. Yeah, the guy that made Family Guy actually made an educational show about space. I have no idea how that happened, but...
Does he go, yeah?
Yeah, everyone falls asleep. He just comes out, No, it's a really, really good show, but every once in a while he talks about stuff, and I'm like, hanging on. I'm like, okay, I don't understand what he said there. I don't understand. No, I don't know what that word is. But every once in a while I'll understand something he says, and it'll be like mind blowing. It'll be like, well, you know, there's planets that circle this, and then there's universes that, or what is it, galaxies that circle galaxies, and then universes that circle universes, and then there's like a multiverse that then holds all of those universes, and then there's a multiverse. And he's like, the theory is that just goes on for infinity, that everything's like, it's like we're just like, our entire universe is just like inside of an atom of another universe.
Sorry, man, but all I heard was,
it blew my mind. It blew my mind. That's all I'm saying.
I like Family Guy.
I do too.
But I want to see that. I want to see that new movie coming out with Seth MacFarlane.
Yeah, the Old West one.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The commercial, he's like going like this. Okay, tell me when to stop. I'll tap you on the head.
Yep.
So funny. I was laughing so hard.
Jerry, you just made a dirty. You just made a dirty thing on my camera. I like. Somebody's gonna meme that. Somebody's gonna meme that dirty gesture you just made.
If only I could do it where I was pointing at your mouth.
Please don't. I would look that way. Like no, stop it.
That impersonation sucks nuts, Jerry. That's what I was going for, actually, though.
What impersonation?
I don't know. I think I was impersonating.
It was Arnold. Were you impersonating the Arnold Schwarzenegger?
No.
Oh.
Get to the chopper.
No, it is my chopper.
Chopper.
Ow!
It's my chopper.
Yeah.
I can't do it as good as you. I just don't. I don't got it. I don't got it, Jerry. I try.
Love the fact that you try.
I do. I really try. Let's see. That show is sick. Oh, talk about NFC.
Near field communication?
I think so.
It's actually kind of dangerous, believe it or not. I'm talking about NFC with credit cards, like the new Chase cards or whatever, the Citibank cards that have the NFC chip, where you can be like, oh, I'm going to pay for this now, and be like, woo, and just wave your wallet and crap. I saw this expose. Ooh, I used a big word there, expose.
Yeah, dude, that had syllables and stuff.
Yeah, I had a couple of them. Where this guy actually had a device about the size of an iPhone, maybe a little bigger, and it picks up near-field communication within, it was like a 10, maybe 10-foot range. And he goes to the mall, and it's like an MSNBC type of expose, right? And they're following him with hidden cameras and stuff. And he walks into a mall, he goes into a toy store, and there's a lady, like, at the register paying, and he kind of just, like, walks up by her and just kind of, it's in his, like, breast pocket of his jacket.
Uh-huh.
And he just kind of, like, walks by this lady really slow, and then it picks up and scans any NFC she had. And it picked up a couple of different credit cards. He then takes out a card scanner, and he, like, swipes a card through the little scanner. You know how you can buy those little card readers? Like the square? was like that. He kind of went through one of those, and the card was already printed with his name and a number or whatever on there. And he programs the card, and then he goes into that same toy store right behind this lady, literally 2 minutes behind her, buys something. And then the news crew like goes out and catches up with this lady, and they're like, hey, you know, here's what just happened. And they show her how he captured her identity, stole and cloned her credit card, and bought something before she was even out of viewing range of the store. And then, you know, he went and returned it. And he was talking about the dangers of NFC communication or NFC technologies with credit cards and things. And if you have NFC enabled on your phone, and then one of the NFC benefits to having, you know, that on like your Samsung S5 or S4 or whatever is the fact that you can load in all of your credit cards, kind of like Passbook for iPhone, but it's all your credit card apps or credit cards put into an app. If your phone is constantly broadcasting NFC, you can get your credit card stolen through that. So yeah. I don't trust NFC at all.
And I don't either.
And the fact that people are always like, oh, iPhone doesn't have NFC. Blah, blah, blah. I'm like, good. I'm a little more protected that way.
Yeah, it's like I actually bought a backpack that has a Faraday cage built into it.
Exactly.
Just so I can put my laptop in there, so if it decides it wants to randomly connect to wireless networks and shit, it can't.
Yeah, I saw your video. God, that was a year ago.
Yeah.
But yeah, they actually sell these special sleeves. They're like little metal sleeves that you can put your card in that go in your wallet to protect the NFC. But at that point, it's like, if you have to buy this shit to protect the NFC, why have it? Why have the NFC? You know, it's like, okay, now we want to turn it off, and you can't, you know, so you have to buy these special wallets and crap.
You know what else is a little scary but also intriguing at the same time is, did you hear about that project where they successfully powered a device off of a Wi-Fi signal?
Wi-Fi power?
The Wi-Fi power. Your actual access point in your house. I was reading about it online, and they said they actually created this device that picks up the radio waves and converts them to energy. So it's a very small amount of energy. It's not a significant amount that you could like run a really high circuit. You couldn't like charge a cell phone really off of it. But they're saying that's the direction that they're going, is that you could eventually have a device that has that's putting out, you know, a lot higher power field, and it wouldn't matter which frequency band it was broadcasting on. You could just use one band for everything, because it doesn't matter if they stomp on each other. All you're doing is utilizing the radio waves to convert back to energy and charge the device. But in theory, sometime in the future, we might be walking around and our cell phones in our pocket might just be charging. You might just walk into a building or walk somewhere and they have these in place, and you're basically, your devices are charging while they're just in your pocket.
Okay, now look, I'm not a doomsdayer and I'm not like a conspiracy theorist, but I don't necessarily think I would want that level of connectivity.
I'm just thinking of like that much radiation, like you got this giant radio frequency. Just, I mean, if it has to be at a high enough power level for your cell phone to charge, it's got to be doing some kind of damage, right? I mean, that's spooky.
As it is, when I fly, I go through the, I automatically opt to go through the pat down, which
you just like the attention,
especially when it's a fat guy named Bob.
You're like, yeah, you better check the groinal area. I don't know if I removed my piece.
I walk up and I go, hey, is he the one doing the pat down? Yep, I opt for the pat down. Yeah, no, no. There was when they first started doing the 3D scanner, there was a whole article that came out of, you know, about how the people who developed that technology really hadn't done any sort of radiation testing on humans to see what the long-term effects were of constantly being hit with that radiation. And they found that the radiation levels, when it was tested by an independent study, was like 16 times the safe limit, right? It was like 20 times that of an X-ray, something like that. And they found it to be actually very invasive, potentially. So
we're all going to get sterilized, but damn it, our phones will charge.
Yeah, like airports like Heathrow, London Heathrow, which is one of the largest airports in the world, like Bandit, wouldn't allow it. And so whenever I see one of those, I just opt immediately for the pat-down. And they don't like that, too. They make you wait longer. You know, they'll just set you over there and make you wait, like, 15 minutes. I get to the airport, like, 3 hours early, even for domestic flights.
They just want to mess with you for slowing things down?
Yeah. Well, not only that, they automatically, if you opt for the pat-down, they automatically assume you're hiding something, because they're like, oh, there's a better chance of missing it in the pat-down. So they're like, they get all up in your crotch and stuff. I'm serious. But I just don't trust those scanners anymore. And I used to fly. I mean, granted, this is the first flight I've taken since I started my YouTube channel 21 months ago. So, but I used to fly every month for my job to all of our different offices in the country doing consulting. And I mean, I'm telling you right now, with the amount of times that I flew, I was like, dude, I'm going to be glowing by the time I'm done. So I finally started going through the pat down, And I'm telling you, the TSA treats you like a criminal by telling you them you want the pat down and won't.
You know what cracks me up though is every time I go through the airport, I've never once had to be pat down, ever, and I've never had to go through the freaking 3D stupid scanner.
And then
I always go through and they just look at me and they're like, all right, put all your crap on the table. Okay, walk through the metal detector.
The airport in Chicago, because I was flying first class, I got to bypass like 1,000 people in that security line. So I didn't have to go through the scanner, but I had to go through the metal detector, which beeped, which makes sense because I do have metal inside my body. So it beeped.
Your nipple piercings?
You ever heard of a Prince John or Prince Albert? No, I'm kidding. So anyway, I go through the metal detector. It beeps. And then I'm thinking they're going to take the little wand and be like, no, they fucking swab my hand. They swab my hand and then put it in a machine and make me stand there until this machine spits out whatever foreign contaminants are on my hand. I'm like, really?
They're like, nope, just Steven, John, let him through.
That's what I was thinking. I was like, what's going to come up with me?
They're like, nope, just the normal 80%, let him through. Oh
my God. Yeah, so it beeps and I go. I didn't even know what to make of that, really. I thought that was a little weird. That's the first time I've ever had my hand swabbed at an airport.
You know what the trick is, Jay? You just have to look guilty as shit, and then they leave you alone. It's like all you got to do. Because every time I go to the airport, I've got like every electronic device I own in my backpack. And I'm sitting there fumbling and shit, trying to get it in the thing, holding up the line. And sweat's beading off my face. And I'm wiping it off. And I forget to take my shoes off. They're like, tell me something. I'm like, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And they just leave me alone. They just push me through nice and calmly. Calm down. It's okay. It's okay. And then they get me on my way. Then the guy comes walking through and he's like, oh, yeah, here's my passport. Get in the fucking scanner. You know, it's like.
Yeah, get him, you little American lemming. You American lemming. You're exactly what the U.S. government's hoping America's going to become.
Oh, hey, my stream of memes is now coming to Twitter. The one where I put my fingers up. Tell me when to stop.
Wait, let me see.
And I'm going to give you a nerdgasm. Oh, these are awesome. I'll give you a nerdgasm.
At least your pinky wasn't sticking out.
Oh, my gosh, dude. Oh, you guys are out of control. I love
no,
it.
No public shockers, Jerry.
No public shockers. All right. I am wearing a sleeveless shirt. I'm surprised has anybody given me shit about that? I haven't seen any shit about that yet. Usually no, I get shit.
I think I'm drawing most of the attention with the hairdo.
I think you are.
I didn't intend to wear this all week. I wore it to work today and people were like, who's the new girl? No, I wasn't intending to wear this all show, but damn, it got kind of comfy.
Did it?
Now it's going to look a little weird. Oh, there we go.
God, look at that guy. What was it? Was it feeling a little comfortable and it kind of felt right, Jay?
It felt right. So wrong, it felt right.
Feel like moving to San Francisco for the weekend?
Miss J and I are going to be taking a weekend trip to San Francisco.
Nice, take the wig with you, man.
I know, right?
Have an interesting time.
I'm going to go into one of them bars where the wife has to wait outside.
Dances with Steve says some lotions show up as explosives. So basically, I went through the airport one time and the guy thought I'd been jacking off. It was hilarious.
Jeez.
Oh my God. I want to do that. I want to just take a suitcase and fill it with like Jergens and just all the different main brands of lotion, just the whole thing packed full of lotion, and just take it there and run it through the scanner. And then just stand at the end with a smirk, like looking her in the eyes the whole time. She's like going through it, be like, yeah.
Jacob Harris is talking about priority flight ticket and it gets you past security. It's funny because at Virgin America, because I had the first class seat, they were like, oh yeah, and this was at at Chicago O'Hare, LAX doesn't have a priority line. At least I went through the overflow, so they didn't have one there. But they were like, oh yeah, just, you see that big line right there? And I'm like, yeah. They're like, just go around that and go to the front and just show them your ticket. And I was like, okay. So I walk around to the front, and there's this old hag of a lady too. And she was like, sir, the line is back there. And I was like, they told me to show you my ticket. She was like, show me what? Oh, okay, come on by. And she waves me by, and they send me down the crew. Like, you know, the crew has their own entrance through security, like the pilots and stuff. They sent me down that line. Next thing I know, if I'm getting shot daggers, like from everybody standing in that line, like ass to nuts, just standing there, not moving, I am just getting shot like laser daggers from everyone's eyes. I felt bad, but at that time, I'm like, you know what? Normally, I'm in that line, so screw you guys. Today is my day. And I can never afford to fly first class again, but hey, whatever.
What's with the priority ticket? How does that like get you out of not having to go through security?
No, I still had to go through security. It's just I got taken to the front of the line.
Oh, okay, that's what it is. Well, somebody was saying something about you can buy a priority ticket and, like, skip through the security check. I'm like...
Priority ticket for most airlines is considered business or first class.
Okay.
And since Virgin doesn't have... And Virgin America, anyway, the domestic airline, doesn't have a business class. They have a first class and a main cabin only.
Gotcha. I'll be honest. I haven't flown a whole lot. I think I've only been on a plane, like, maybe 4 times in my life. I mean, I don't do a lot of flying. I really don't.
I think I've been to every major airport in the country a couple of times. This feels that way.
Well, I think at some point I probably will travel more. We'll see.
We'll
see where this YouTube thing takes me, Jay.
Somebody was supposed to hop on a plane and fly down this way for a while there.
I know, but then I heard about your crack addiction. I didn't want to come down there and, you know, cause problems.
You were supposed to come down here and... Never mind, I won't even... Never mind.
It's going to happen, Jay. It's going to happen.
No, it's not. I'm going to end up going up to Seattle for PAX before you ever make your ass down here.
That's possible, but it's going to happen.
I'm debating pulling out of PAX Prime, though.
Why?
Just because of the timing and all that. It's going to be in Jennifer's third trimester.
Oh, that's true. That's true.
Well, it's going to be the beginning of the trimester.
Well, just keep giving me grief. Keep giving me grief, and I'll come down there eventually. It's going to happen. Just keep griefing me. That's all I got to do is keep griefing me.
It doesn't matter. Griefing you doesn't... Look, you know how to handle the trolling. Griefing you doesn't do anything.
But Jay, I actually care about you. You're like,
it's like, huh? Jerry's got 100,000 subscribers now. He's too big for me. Yep. Oh.
I didn't say that. You asshole. To God, that's how you like perceive me. There's like people that actually believe you too. It's like, oh, that Jerry guy. He used to be different. Actually, I do get that a lot though. I do get a lot of people that are
You're
like,
not the same guy you were when you started.
I remember when you had 25 subs and used to talk to everybody 24 hours a day. I'm like, what are you talking about on Twitter? I still do.
I know.
I've got 8,000 people on Twitter, and it's like I still respond to almost everything.
The analog kid 94, Jay, what is your real job? I have many jobs, actually. Talk about Chicago. They had really good pizza. Downtown is very claustrophobic. I did not like downtown. Lincoln Park Zoo was kind of interesting. And I flew home. So.
Oh, Chicago. Hey, new meme up. 2 in the pink, 1 in the, wait, what? Because there's no pinky out.
Oh, dear me.
Oh, man. I love our community. Oh, God. Yeah. Time flies, man. It's already 7:08.
Yeah. Guys.
It's up before everybody leaves.
We only guarantee an hour, and every now and then you get an extra few minutes like you did today. So it's time to say goodbye.
Gotta say goodbye. Hey, we got 483 likes, though, and we thank you for each and every one.
Absolutely. Thank you. Jay, how are you? Good. Rock on, brother, man.
And to the 16 people that disliked this stream, no apologies.
None whatsoever.
Go watch PewDiePie.
I think we got more dislikes initially on this than we did the drunk stream.
I know the drunk stream. Oh, yes.
People were like, hey, I started getting messages from people saying, hey, you missed 2 weeks. Does that mean twice as drunk? I was like, oh, God.
If you guys ever want to see the drunk stream, you have to basically go harvest Jay's entire Twitter feed for like the last month or two to find the link, because it is.
It's deeply hidden. I can't even find it myself. Remember I was telling you, I was like, yeah. I can't even find it. When I look through my video history, it's not there, but people have still linked it. So
but if you find the link, it is funny. Mm-hmm. Unless you're against alcohol. Then
it's an hour and a half of just from the first 15 minutes. I couldn't remember anything from 15 minutes beyond.
True story.
Anyway. All right, guys. Time to get out of here. Happy 100K, Jerry. That's going to happen like tomorrow.
Thank you. Until everybody like unsubs me now after they watch this, you ass.
Unsub. I'll give you $1. All right.
If they unsub, I'd commit suicide, but then they just unsub faster.
You're back to like 4,000 right now.
You internet peoples are mean. You are mean peoples.
Assholes.
But I still love you. All right.
Roll the outro. Oh.